National parks had to follow the government's lead and shut down too.
And that affects tourism and jobs. News 4's Mike McCormick with the proof here locally.
Employees locked up and left the Cowpens National Battlefield Tuesday morning.
For us, it puts 15 employees here at Cowpens on furlough.
Superintendent John Slaughter calls it devastating.
We are certainly looking forward to getting back into business.
That won't happen till the government is back in business.
I think it is a disgrace.
The battlefield was a stop on Beverly Clark Fultz's trip from Kentucky.
My brother, my sister-in-law, and my husband, we're out sharing a mutual birthday.
Roger Bowling and his wife drove to the battlefield from Vero Beach, Florida.
Well, it was disappointing.
A 700-mile motorcycle ride.
Something I knew all about, I've read about many, many times, and I wanted to see.
Even the park's trails are closed.
I hate to see it closed down.
Diane Scruggs and Robbie Satterfield drove 25 minutes to run here.
We do love this place up here. It's beautiful.
The battlefield is part of the Upstate Revolutionary War weekend, which starts Friday, so the shutdown could impact that, too.
Democrats, wake up. Republicans, wake up. Listen to your people. Listen to the people of the United States of America. We detest this.
This is even having an impact on social media. Take a look. This is the Cowpens National Battlefield's Facebook page. And as you scroll on down, their latest post reads, because of the federal government shutdown, this National Park Service Facebook page is inactive. We'll start the conversation again when we get back. Mike McCormick, WYFF News 4 in Gaffney.
And if the battlefield stays closed through the Revolutionary War weekend, events like encampments will be held elsewhere in Gaffney and Cherokee County. Walnut Grove Plantation, which remains open, will host events as planned.